Uncovering evidence of alien life would surely be one of the most significant and exciting discoveries in the history of science. But really, what are the chances of finding life alive at the same time as us? The universe is 13.8 billion years old, and modern humans have only been around for the last 2 to 300,000 years of that time. The numbers are certainly against us, so might we be better off searching for things that an alien force could have left behind instead? This is Unveiled, and today we're exploring a new application of the Drake Equation to ask, should we search the moon for alien artifacts? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. Even just on Earth, studying ancient cultures is difficult. Arguably the best way to peer into the past, though, is to find physical remains of older civilizations that have somehow been preserved through time. Discovering written documents is also a great way to learn about those of the past, but we know that not every culture developed a language or system of writing, so it doesn't always come good. Plain artifacts, on the other hand, allow us to glimpse how lost cultures and civilizations lived and worked. Artifacts can really be anything that a civilization leaves behind. Clothes, tools, pieces of art, anything made during the time they were alive. Of course, a civilization likely makes thousands of items during its reign, but much of those are ultimately lost as well. Scavengers can find and destroy them, but there are also Earth's natural forces to contend with. Water can consume and submerge artifacts, rain and wind can erode away their material, and natural events like earthquakes and landslides can completely bury them. As it's constantly recycling itself, Earth isn't especially built for preservation. Given enough time, things decay and disintegrate in this world. So it takes a lot of luck to find well-preserved artifacts here. Other places in the solar system are much more suited to preservation, however. Today's target, the moon, doesn't have many of the natural processes that would decay or break any objects on its surface, for example. It has very little atmosphere, which means no weather or rain to cause erosion, and there's no oxygen gas to bring about decay. And although the moon does sometimes suffer from moonquakes, tectonic processes are minimal, so potential artifacts are less likely to be recycled that way too. In fact, it's no exaggeration to say that objects on the lunar surface could go unbothered for thousands, nay millions of years, with the only real danger to them being a perpetually possible, but also unlikely, massive asteroid impact. That, or they might soon be looted by the first waves of space tourists, which is actually a very real concern for some scientists and campaigners, with calls for laws to be created to protect human lunar artifacts that are already there, such as rovers, flags, and footprints. But still, unless they are removed, then it figures that whatever's on the moon right now could very well outlast our entire species. If something catastrophic were to happen to humanity tomorrow, then everything on Earth would eventually disappear. But anything on the moon could find itself retained deep into the future. And these preservative qualities have continually interested another band of researchers too, those looking for signs of alien life. SETI, or the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, primarily focuses at present on listening to radio signals in the hope of hearing something alien. But that might not be the best way to go about it. Radio signals fade with time and distance, and they pass by any one place only once, meaning they're easy to miss. Artifacts, on the other hand, are potentially there forever, as good as new from day one to day 1 billion. Back in 2004, a professor Christopher Rose of Rutgers University also highlighted how it takes significantly more energy to send even mid-reaching radio waves than it does to create a thing to leave it in hope that it's one day found. Another SETI scientist, Seth Shostak, has since backed up that suggestion. showing that under various conditions, an effective radio message would take billions, perhaps trillions, of watts of power, and more than the entire energy intake of humankind. And ultimately, that's for just a simple one-note greeting. In short, then, the argument goes that if it wanted to be found, an alien force might be better to mail us packages rather than call us up. Of course, we humans have left a so-called message in a bottle ourselves before, with the golden records on the Voyager probes, which could theoretically travel without fading for millions of years before they are found. They're arguably still our greatest hope of reaching out to an extraterrestrial species. So the question is, why don't we more vigorously look for alien equivalents of those records, ready-made for us? It seemingly forms at least part of the thinking behind physicist James Benford's recent suggestion that we should shift away from traditional SETI toward a SETA approach instead, a search for extraterrestrial artifacts. Benford, who had his study published in summer 2021, has modified the Drake equation, a famous formula used to predict the possibility of other life in the universe. He applied it instead, however, to calculate the odds of finding alien artifacts in space. And ultimately, he showed that humans are about as likely to find evidence of intelligent life by looking for artifacts as they are by searching space in the usual way, for radio waves. Although this had been suggested before, Benford puts forward a model to show mathematically the potential for first contact that it offers. So, with this in mind, where should be the first place that we look, and really look, in depth for artifacts? Given all that we know about how well things preserve there, and given that it's the closest thing to us, it's little wonder that some, including Benford, argue in favor of us scouring the moon. The chances of life having passed by there are in many, even most ways, quite slim. Yes, the moon has been around for roughly 4.5 billion years, stoically paired with the Earth, but it's still but one object in an endless universe full of objects. On the other hand, if anything alien has ever stopped by, then the chances of artifacts being preserved there are very high. We know that for ourselves, again thanks to the human artifacts that remain in place up there. If we were to more actively pursue any SETA initiatives, then Benford and other researchers point to the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, or LRO, as being the most important tool we have. The LRO is a spacecraft that's been taking pictures of the moon ever since it was launched in 2009. So far, it snaps more than 90% of the lunar surface, with the only regions still lacking being the polar regions. And these images aren't your classic, super grainy, barely legible space photos either. They're high-resolution shots, clear enough that some artifacts have already been spotted among them, although all to date have been those human artifacts from previous human missions. For those then, like Benford, who want more done in the search for artifacts, we should be setting up larger, dedicated teams to analyze the LRO data, and we should be combing through it, specifically looking for alien objects. But what's your verdict? Is it worth upping the search for artifacts at all? Or should we just stick with what we've been doing for years, by putting more of our resources toward traditional radio messaging? And also, if artifacts are the way to go, then is looking for them on the moon the best course of action? In regards to his proposal that we would be best searching for objects, James Benford has also spoken on what he calls lurkers, which are, broadly speaking, advanced probes similar to Bracewell probes that might theoretically hide themselves away from us, but watch and relay information all the same. There's no current evidence that there is a lurker on the moon, but could our lunar satellite actually be the best place for one? If you were piloting a lurker from far away, and you wanted to look into what was happening on Earth, where would you set up base? For now, we still have our own limitations to work within. The moon is closest to us. We've been there before. and we should be going back again soon. Perhaps that's enough in itself to warrant a full lunar hunt for long-lost alien relics. It's by no means the only place in even the solar system where objects of interest might be hiding, but you gotta start somewhere, right? And that's why perhaps we should try searching the moon for alien artifacts. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.